Carlow's a great place to start this week because just chatting to some people down there, and the St Mullins manager Niall O'Donnell, after the way they beat Ballinkillen after extra time there against Mount Leinster this Sunday, but he said it's taken unmerciful energy out of us now. That's the one thing. So this county final that's coming on a bit too fast for us. Probably the one winner there is Mount Leinster Rangers there, I'd imagine. So poor Mountain, because you had to go to extra time a week before the final. What do you think of that?
So you have to paint it whatever way you think to paint it. Like, everything is about a cause, almost. Like, it's trying to set it up to put yourself in the best situation. Mount Leinster, while in theory to some people Mount Leinster are sitting there, sitting pretty, waiting. I don't know if waiting is ever a good thing. There's no practice matches and training will never get you prepared for. Yeah. They had an absolute dogfight of a match last week. The only thing that matters is that they came through that. Doesn't matter, and nothing else matters. All the energy expended, they're in the county final exactly where they wanted to be. But sure, poor Mountain is what the chase is all about.
But the far more of a concern is something that's ongoing as we speak. There's an appeal in to try and get Jack Kavanagh off from a red card and a suspension that he got. Now, he's gotten plenty of red cards over the years, so I don't know if that will count into it. But Conor Phelan is training Mount Leinster Rangers. He's from Clara, and I don't know if people remember him, but He did that interview when Clara won the Kilkenny title in 2013.
Came
really,
on as a late kind of sub that day, yeah.
Very, very emotional sort of an interview because, like, he had to give up hurling for a number of years. Now, he was originally, he would have been on the under 21 team, I think, with the likes of Tommy Walsh and all these lads coming up. And he won an under 21 All Ireland. He had a senior medal with Kilkenny from 2003.
He was probably slated for a decade long career, probably, with Kilkenny.
And no doubt All Ireland's and All Stars to wash it down, But, like, he had to have surgery on a defective heart valve in 2014, told he would never hurl again, came back again in 2016 as a sub against Ballyhale in the semi final. But he had. I think that issue kind of first came up around 05 after Noel Hickey. He'd had that heart issue.
Yeah. They all screened. Got screened as part of the GPA had brought it in, I think, and Kenny got them all screened.
And that's where Conor Phelan had his issue diagnosed, and so he had to give up hurling. So when he got back and got that county title in 2013, he was kind of choking back the tears in the interview. So it was great stuff, But Mount Leinster, they have had some amount of success lately, and they're going for 3 in a row at senior as they're transitioning the team. But this year, they've won the under 13, under 15. They're in the under 11 and intermediate finals on Saturday, and the minor on Sunday, and obviously the senior on Sunday.
Funny, same colours, it sounds exactly like Ballygunner. Ballygunner are playing the intermediate final this weekend, their second team like in the intermediate final. But funny enough, when Burr were going really well, Burr did 3 in a row of intermediate titles.
Wow.
While winning senior, and you had to regrade 7 every year. So from the 99 team, 7 of them couldn't play in 2000. And likewise,
couldn't play on that intermediate team?
No, couldn't play the following year because obviously, otherwise, it's just the same team every year and directly the same team could win. So 7 were regraded again from 2000 to 2001. Now, some of them would have naturally come back, but like for those clubs to be doing that, I know they might have maybe better numbers than some of the rural teams. But it's a fair achievement.
Ah, unreal. And like you see that, I saw it in Dublin, Ballyboden's second team, when they were winning all those county titles. Very, very strong. I think the last couple of years, Coola went from 2 adult teams and the second one could barely field up to 4. So, and obviously Dublin's a different case.
So like just Kilcarnock, Killarney in Offaly would be a great example. Won the Junior B, were beaten in the Junior A final, retained Senior B status, and we beat them in the senior semi-final. Like, that's 4 teams. And, like, there's so much jiggery-pokery with lads as well to make sure lads are still eligible and stuff like that. So it's fair going.
Some of the matchups for this game. So St Mullins have a lot of threats. The likes of James Doyle, very good. Marty Kavanagh, everyone knows about him. Mouse Kavanagh doing a lot of scoring for Carlow.
Just a quick one. Did Marty Kavanagh get an All-Star nomination? I don't think he did.
I don't think so. Catch me on the hop there as well.
There's another one. I was only thinking about it the other day. Like,
we're flaking away at the All-Star committee every week.
No, it's just Marty Kavanagh I saw and just deliver some serious league performance, serious championship performance. So.
Paul Doyle is on that team, Philip Connors. Seamus Murphy will be playing centre forward against Richard Cody, who'll be centre back for Mount Leinster. That's definitely an important one. Eddie Byrne will be full forward for Mount Leinster and he'll be up against Paul Doyle, so that's 2 county men. And then midfield, assuming Jack Kavanagh gets off, it's a battle of 4 county players for Carlow. So you're going to have James Doyle and Jack Kavanagh on one side and then Kevin MacDonald and Dermot Byrne on the other. So
the funny thing about this is I remember chatting Marty Kavanagh before. He has a ball of cousins playing for Mount Leinster. The amount of cousins crossing over here is just unbelievable. Like, I think it's Marty Kavanagh's mother, I think, is from Mount Leinster. And they're all the best friends and teammates with playing with Carlow. They're basically our brothers, essentially. They're all related. And then they're the best of enemies then when they play each other in big games.